Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Marsaction Infinite Ambition on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Marsaction Infinite Ambition and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Marsaction Infinite Ambition. So without further ado, let's get to it. Before anything else buddies, the first thing to do is to open our favorite internet browser. We selected the one we use by default. Let's continue, going to this URL that I have highlighted in green. There you are seeing it on the screen of the PC. There is no need to type anything, because there's the link in the video description and as well in the first main comment. We arrived at this point on our site of Usitility, exactly where we get an in-depth outline on the best way to obtain Marsaction Infinite Ambition on computer. We browse lower a bit and mouse click on the download game on PC button. Once clicking on this link, we get to the site of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we will run to play Marsaction Infinite Ambition on the PC. As you can see here, we have several advantages of running that emulator. Then, we are ready to proceed to download the Marsaction Infinite Ambition by simply clicking on the button play on BlueStacks that I have marked in green color. We then click on it. Of course, the download starts and ends immediately. Voila, this is the download. It's a file we have to execute. What we have to do now is to launch the executable file. Okay, so we click on this file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to allow changes to the laptop or device. We said yes. I reduce the internet browser to see the installation software better. The installation software is very simple to use. It consists of a couple of choices: install and setup path. I am going to talk about what setup path does indeed. We basically just click it. And then we realize that we get here the path where the emulator is going to be set up. If we plan to modify this folder, we have to click on this browse button. So we select another directory and set up the emulator wherever we like. To keep it simple, just keep it by default. I click on back, and therefore I just click install. Great, the setup starts and it is going to move forward together with the download of all these megabytes that happens to be shown on that screen. The moment you download it, it could possibly be a bit more or less megabytes. The data transfer rate might go faster or slower, depending on your internet and according to the speed of the emulator web servers. Today they're going rather fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At this time, the emulator happens to be launched successfully. As you can see now, at the bottom of the screen, there is a progress bar which will fill up, so when it comes to the finish, the emulator is launched for the very first time. Believe it or not, the emulator has been launched there for the first time. Before we continue on, as now you can see, it has created a couple of software icons right here on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks software icon is going to be the one we are interested in. At any time when we are planning to operate Marsaction Infinite Ambition on the desktop or laptop, we twice click this particular icon and launch the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in eco mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Let me conduct the next step, which is actually a requirement, and that's to begin to browse the Google Play Store. And we are going to just click on Play Store. As can be seen, the Google Play is started. There we are required to sign in. Right now, once we are on this page, we are required to begin doing this following step that is definitely compulsory. Therefore we click on Sign In. At present it shows checking info. It can once in a while get blocked in checking info, and this isn't going to progress. In that case, you may try to connect to your account after a couple of hours, but it will surely very likely be resolved. At present we can type in our email address and password. The email is required to be a Gmail email address as well as its related password. For instance, you can use the same exact email you use currently in your YouTube account. Then I am going to provide my data and I will come back after I have done it. That's all, info entered. Find out Google welcoming us and providing us the twos. We can say yes to all of them simply by clicking on, I agree. Then, it make us possible to backup to the Google Cloud. You can also let it check it's going to produce a backup of the files on this device to Google Drive. I will not select it, you do what you want. We mouse click on accept. The Google Play Store is started by default and completely on its own. To set up the app game, we are required to visit the emulator desktop for Android by left-clicking that icon indicated in green. Currently that we are discovering the desktop of the emulator for Android, we observe that we now have there the install video game option. We mouse click on that button. At this point we come with the game. Let's press there on the install link that I am presenting now in green. This will launch the installation. Presently it should download and install the video game. It typically takes a little while or it may be amazingly quickly. It all is going to depend on our own connection to the internet. This has actually completed installing. Back to the emulator desktop by clicking that option that I'm presenting in green, that allows you to run Marsaction Infinite Ambition for the very first time. I am currently on the emulator desktop, and consequently we are about to just click on the brand new Marsaction Infinite Ambition software icon which has been generated. That game app is launched for the first time on your computer. Currently there we get it, I can also press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I am going to discuss the volume of that emulator. It's here, we use the icon of higher volume and also the icon of lower volume. This manner we are not going to rely on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound experience of the emulator. As well as to take pleasure in the experience to the fullest, we will switch on the big screen, for which we have two choices. That is actually the first one, we then click on this particular software icon which I'm designating in green. Then the monitor is maximized, getting one border at the top, one on the right side and one at the bottom. In the case that we need to appreciate the application in full screen, we hit that app icon. So we would likely by now be experiencing and enjoying the video game in full screen function. To get out of the complete screen setting, push the F11 key. And we might by now play in regular computer screen setting. From now, I am on the way to reveal you the computer keys mapping that is actually rather exciting. That means we may be able to operate the game much more effortlessly. The very first task is to click this computer keyboard icon. And right now there you will have the ability to make the recommended adjustments. I am about to put the standard settings, however if you wish to change this, you can also do it now without having problem. Clearly, the emulator is fully in our language. On occasion it happens that the emulator is presented in the incorrect language, such as, in Chinese language. And as a result to place it in the right language we browse here to the cogwheel. So there within many other configurations, we just click on the language drop down. We may very well opt for the language we need, Spanish, Japanese, etc. As soon as the language is chosen, we should save, the emulator will restart, as well as the video game, the next time we launch it, would also be in the picked language. Right now, you can find another aspect that we have to take into account, and it's that we will get an email telling you that a brand new machine has been connected to this Google account. It should question us if we're the people who have associated with that device. Of course, we should not worry, because the emulator is acting as an Android electronic device. And in order to determine which device is currently being emulated, we return here, to the cogwheel and we then click on it. Be sure to browse here to the model option. And now we notice that the emulator is acting as a Samsung mobile. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it guys, so much for this video user demo. I believe you enjoyed it, specifically that you thought it was handy. In that case, give it a superb like, subscribe to our channel, and if you have remarks, requests or suggestions, let them in the comment box below. You can also leave a remark on my Twitch channel, I do live streams every now and then. You have it listed below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Simply click any of the instructional videos that happens to be appearing on the computer screen and let's have fun again in the future video tutorials. Bye.